Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. I want to talk about what you must know if you don't have a gallbladder. Okay. People are told they don't need the gallbladder. It's an unnecessary organ and you won't have any problems. But there's some long-term effects. First of all, what is the gallbladder? Okay. It's a little sac that hangs underneath your liver, about the size of a little potato. And there's a tube that comes from your liver and this little sac that hangs off this tube. All right. But the key is what it holds, what it stores. The gallbladder stores and holds bile. Okay. B-I-L-E. What is bile? Bile is the very important fluid that helps you absorb fats, absorb fatty soluble vitamins, regulate cholesterol, help balance hormones. So it does a lot. It helps lubricate the colon. Okay, so we'll talk about all those. But basically, without a gallbladder, you don't have the concentrated effect. Normally, the bile is concentrated by 5 times the amount in that little sac there. So we need that bile to secrete out when you eat fats to be able to pull it in. So without that gallbladder, you're always going to be deficient in bile. Okay, it's just going to trickle down because it's made by the liver. It's going to trickle down. And by the way, bile is what prevents gallstones. So probably the reason why you had a gallstone in the first place is you don't have enough bile. So now they take the gallbladder out and you don't have the bile, you continue to have other problems. Okay, so let's take a look at, without a gallbladder, all the potential issues. Number one, you're not going to balance the cholesterol anymore. Cholesterol is necessary in the building of hormones, specifically stress hormones, okay? But other hormones too, like testosterone, they're made from cholesterol. Your brain needs cholesterol, the nerves need cholesterol. So also free cholesterol needs bile to help break it down. So you can have more of a buildup of cholesterol without bile. So we have an imbalance of cholesterol, the good and bad. Okay, that's number one. Number two, you may find that you're not actually eliminating toxins. Why? Because all the toxins go through this bile duct when they come and they're eliminated. So the bile helps in the breakdown of toxins and the elimination of toxins. Not to mention the lubrication of the colon, so you may end up with constipation. Okay. Now, the next one is thyroid. T4, the inactive thyroid hormone, is converted to T3. Through the liver and the gallbladder. So without a gallbladder, your thyroid can suffer in that it won't convert. So you might end up with a thyroid issue, which affects a whole host of problems because we need that gallbladder to do the conversion. Okay, so the other one is preventing fatty liver, because the fat can actually build up in the liver if you don't have the bile. Bile breaks down fat. Now, if you don't have the fat-soluble vitamins, vitamin A, the vision suffers. You won't be able to see at night when you're driving in the dark. The vision just kind of goes down with vitamin. You need vitamin A in general for your vision, okay? The skin becomes dry. You have issues with skin. The inner skin of the inner sinuses become a problem. Sinus problems, sleep apnea, immune system, that's all vitamin A. Vitamin D is the regulation of calcium. So you may find that your calcium is off, especially the metabolism of calcium. You get bone pain, you have issues with the immune system, things like that. And then also when people are low in vitamin D, they have problems with depression during the wintertime because they don't have enough vitamin D. Vitamin D is also good to prevent asthma as well. Okay, vitamin E, very essential for the heart. Vitamin E increases the oxygen to the heart by 250 times. 250%. So it actually increases oxygen to the heart to prevent heart cramps. It's great as an anti-angina nutrient. Vitamin E is also called the anti-sterility, so it prevents becoming sterile. It helps fertility. Vitamin E is important in the skin. So many women use it on their skin, vitamin E oil. But then we got vitamin K1. That's to prevent bruising and to help clotting. Vitamin K2 prevents the soft tissue calcium from building up in the arteries and the joints. Very, very important. There's even certain phytonutrients like plant-based chemicals in like the cruciferous vegetables that are fat-soluble too. Like we have leucopene, lutein, carotenoids, those are all fat-soluble. Those are all very, very important in protecting the eye, protecting against macular degeneration, just helping you see in general. So those are fat-soluble. So, and then also you're not going to absorb the omega-3 fatty acids. Like, think about why you need omega-3 fatty acids. That's all anti-inflammatory. I mean, it's precursors to build body tissue, so many issues. So these are just a small list of potential issues that you could have if you don't have a gallbladder, okay? So I hope that gave you some enlightenment. The question is, what do you do if you don't have a gallbladder? Well, what I would recommend is to take some type of bile support to supplement your body so when you eat, you have enough bile to prevent these issues. But you have to realize that it's going to be a slow process. It doesn't happen overnight. So you may see symptoms months after the gallbladder is removed. All right. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next videos.